What's going on YouTube? It's Ganem Mo. One of our favorite all-time books is Rich Dad, Poor Dad. The lessons learned from reading that book were so instrumental on our journey to achieving wealth and financial freedom.
Let us be the first to introduce you to this healthcare edition of one of your favorite finance books and ours, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Except this time around, it's going to be called Rich Doctor, Poor Doctor. Let us introduce to you the tale of two doctors. Dr. Rich, who has done very well with his or her money to get rich and stay rich over the years. And Dr. Poor, who, well, hasn't done so well and therefore resulted in them not being rich and poor due to poor financial decision making. So let's get on this journey together and explore their stories. But first, gingerly tap that like button and let's get started.
Dr. Rich stuck to some principles in her or her journey to achieving wealth, and those principles demonstrate a tale of early sacrifices as well as proper financial planning. Dr. Rich took the following steps on the journey to riches and wealth, had a written investment plan, and that includes a very well thought out plan that actually tells you where the money goes each month, how much money goes to saving, how much money goes to expenses, how much money goes to retirement and college. And it actually tells you what the returns on your investments are. Dr. Rich started early and still continues the journey of financial education. Time was put to the side and prioritized to learn about financial education and to become financially literate through reading, through learning, and through networking to expand the financial knowledge and skills.
The rich doctor made it a point to start saving 20% of their income the minute they finished residency, when they started earning the big bucks. And they were able to minimize their debt throughout their training and into their attending years. And any debt that they did have, they were able to manage it pretty well. They were able to use the good debt in order to produce income leveraging assets, such as real estate, and grow their business alongside of it. And they probably didn't have as much student loan debt as many other healthcare professionals find themselves having. The rich doctor quickly got a second job out of residency, if they weren't already moonlighting already. And they quickly realized that their skills are essential and they can maximize their skills to produce more income. Therefore, they got on staff at multiple hospitals and offices in order to generate more income. Therefore, they were able to reach financial independence earlier and retire earlier. They believed in sacrificing now in order to produce and generate wealth for the future was well worth it. The rich doctor reinvested a portion of their income into assets and businesses that still produce some passive income to this day.
Dr. Rich favors a passive investing approach by realizing that stock pickers along with market timers can't outperform the market when the costs are included. As such, low-cost index investing was always favored. Dr. Rich was not afraid to take ownership risk, and that includes a high stock allocation in the portfolio, owning some rental properties, owning a side business, or owning her own practice. That's because Dr. Rich realized that rich people own things.
Dr. Rich made it a point to insure themselves and their families against potential catastrophes that may occur by owning occupational disability insurance and short-term life insurance policies. And they made it a point never to mix insurance policies and investing together. Just go visit one of our favorite YouTube channels, Disability Insurance Queen, who has a plethora of information about this. Beware of anybody trying to sell you whole life insurance policies and annuities. And the rich doctor made it a point to play alongside the IRS playbook legally by minimizing their expenses and taxes and maximizing their tax deductions throughout the year.
Dr. Rich made it a point to always protect the assets, plan the estate, and always staying the course. Dr. Rich never sold during a bear's market and always stuck to the investing plan. Dr. Rich got a trust and a will and consulted with an attorney once the assets approached the estate tax exemption limit. On a personal note, Dr. Rich always had the following to say when anyone seeked him for money advice. One spouse, one house. Spend money on quality and spend money on experiences.
Dr. Rich doesn't care what you think about their broken down beater sitting in the doctor's parking garage on the first floor next to the entrance. They don't care that the doctor next to them is driving a Tesla Model S 2020 black on black that's able to drive themselves. They don't like to play this game of keeping up with the Joneses. They truly love being a healthcare professional. And the lesson we can get from Dr. Rich is, love what you do more than the doctor next to you. Find your passion in your career and the rest will come easy and wealth will build upon that. You don't have to sit living paycheck to paycheck throughout your whole career. We believe that Dr. Rich deserves a gingerly tapping of that like button for a stellar job that they did of creating their wealth and maintaining it.
Now on to Dr. Poor. Dr. Poor made many decisions that resulted in the financial bind that he or she finds themselves in. Dr. Poor allowed societal and family obligations guide the lifestyle and purchases. Dr. Poor allowed pent-up delayed gratifications get the best of him, resulting in poor financial decisions such as using a credit card, buying too big of a house, spending too much on a wedding, and allowing lifestyle to creep upwards with the increased income.
Dr. Poor found themselves to be the target of the financial industry throughout their whole entire career and didn't realize it until it was too late. That person giving him or her financial advice was just a saleswoman or a man in a suit looking out for his or her own best interest. They took financial advice from their friends, co-workers, and family members who had no experience in the financial space whatsoever, and they tried guiding them in what stocks to pick and what's hot out tomorrow and what's new now in order to make that quick buck out of them. But Dr. Poor always got steered into the wrong direction. They tried to keep up with the Joneses and bought front-loaded mutual funds along the way. They liked to buy the most expensive cars, the biggest house, and the nicest clothes, all to look rich, but never to be wealthy.
Dr. Poor lacked understanding of the progressive tax code, as well as thinking that money is a renewable resource, thinking that additional spending will result in more happiness, and spending all the money in the checking account. Dr. Poor failed to realize how much needs to be saved up for retirement and education. He failed to start a 529 plan early for his children and insisted on them going to a private college.
They overpaid for legal fees and didn't find the right CPA that would be able to minimize their expenses and taxes and maximize their tax deductions. They quit one job and moved on to the next because they were never satisfied with the amount of money they were making because they needed more of it in order to maintain their lifestyle. They never understood that saving money early on in their career to maximize compound interest would benefit them in the long run. They needed to live in the moment and didn't want to sacrifice. The message that we can take from Dr. Poor is be smart with your money. As a healthcare professional, you are bound to make a lot of money throughout your career, and that is based on your income. But utilize that money to make more money and to generate wealth. Don't be like Dr. Poor and waste it all away to find yourself at 65, unable to retire and enjoy life. Be like Dr. Rich. Go to work because you love it, not because you have to. Don't live paycheck to paycheck.
There you have it, a tale of two doctors, Dr. Rich and Dr. Poor. What do you think? Why are some doctors richer than others? Is it due to genetic? Is it due to environment? Is it due to proper financial planning? Or a combination of the above? Are you the rich doctor next door? Do you know any?
And let us know what you think of Dr. Rich and Dr. Poor by commenting down below and subscribing to our channel. We upload videos every Monday and Friday, so stay tuned.